Hi, my name is Eddie Jackson, and this is Real True Street Crime. I'm not doing this video here for hits, because I know it's not going to get any. So this video is not for hits. Understand this, I'm just speaking my mind. I don't understand how we stand around and cheer two billionaires who don't pay any taxes going to space, Jeff Bezos and Virgin. What are they doing for this world but throwing away millions and billions and millions of dollars going to space? People are dying of corona. People are starving and hungry, and they don't even pay taxes. I could have no complaint with either of those men if they paid taxes. My father had to pay taxes. Why don't they? That's my question to you all. Why are we sitting around celebrating a bunch of tax dodgers and non-taxpayers to this country? That's why you don't have NAFTA. our Florida space program that we had, because rich folks don't want to pay taxes. They'll rather do it themselves instead of pay taxes and let the government do it how it's always been done. We've always had a space program. Now we don't. We counting on millionaires and billionaires to be our space program, which is totally going in the wrong direction. Totally the wrong direction. Let me say this. Our sister, for smoking a joint, and weed is legal. It was legal where she smoked it at. It's legal in the country. How are you going to hold her off the Olympic team because she smoked marijuana? That is a disgrace. Because you will hear a year from now, they're going to have to make an exception for that to the Olympics, because all the players do it, not just her. She's not the only one of them smoke weed. Don't you ever think that. Most of them do. I'm not going to say they all smoke weed, but I guarantee you at least 70% of everybody going to the Olympics smoke weed. I would say 30% don't. I would say 70% do. That's my evaluation of it. Understand this. I think it's the wrongest thing you can do not to let that sister go run because she smoked the joint. It's just like having our brothers in jail for selling weed, and weed is legal. It's a miscarriage of justice in every way. Everything I'm watching, from Jeff Bezos and Virgin paying no taxes, a space race between billionaires, and they want all us poor folks to sit down here and cheer them on as they spend all the money and pay no taxes to do anything to help roads, school. Pay attention to this. When Hillary Clinton was running against Donald Trump, she said it best. If you don't pay taxes, you ain't helping us fix roads, infrastructure, schools, nothing. But you call them two great people, and they don't even pay taxes to help anyone. Understand that. That's a disgrace on this world for Bill Gates, Jeff Bezos, Virgin Records, not to pay taxes. And then to flaunt all this wealth in front of us like we should be cheering them racing the space. I don't want to see it. Understand that. It does not interest me at all because they don't have a heart to help the poor. The money they spend in racing the space, they could be helping the poor who needs it during corona. They busy trying to kick poor people off of unemployment and all of this and don't make any of them pay taxes. This is a disgrace in this country, and there's got to be something done about it. We need people that's honest running for office, because what we have now is a bunch of dishonesty in every way, shape, and form. There is no way in this world Bill Gates, Jeff Bezos, and Virgin shouldn't be paying taxes. I know y'all don't want to hear this, so I'm not doing it for hits. I'm doing it to put it out there for somebody else who might listen and pay attention to really what's going on. The miscarriages of justice. How you gonna have these men spending billions of dollars going to space and they don't pay any taxes? What is that doing for the average man? What did Virgin trip to space do for you? What will Jeff Bezos trip to space do for you in 9 days? Tell me, what will it do for the poor man? What will it do for the infrastructure? What will it do for the struggling schools? And I'm gonna bring up one more point to you all, and I'm gone. The lottery. The lottery is supposed to fund schools. It's not doing that. Politicians are stealing the money. You got billion and billion dollar drawings on a lottery and the schools are broke, no computers, no nothing. Where's all them billions and billions and billions and billions of dollars going to? They're not being accounted for by the people. When the lottery was started, it was started in the thing of it, all the money would go to schools. Now the money got so big, schools, they're not giving it to schools. That's a disgrace. Make them stand up from what they said from the beginning. They said the money would go to fund and help schools, and the lottery money is not doing that. I don't care what nobody say. You got damn near billion-dollar drawings, and the schools are hurting worse than they ever hurt it. So where is all this money going from the lottery? Another miscarriage of justice. You took it from us, the black people, who was running numbers and calling it illegal. You take the shit, put it in the store, and say it's helping the kids, and the kids are starving worse than ever in the Michigan lottery, Florida lottery, California, Chicago. All the lottery games are blowing up, and the schools are going down. How can that be? Make them honor their promise to the kids. They don't even love kids in this country anymore. Mitch McConnell can't love them with all the guns he's got on the streets. The NRA cannot love kids the way they see them being killed, and they study pumping more military-grade weapons out here to kill them with. This is a miscarriage of justice. Your Republican Party is nothing more than a party of wrongdoing and standing up to for a liar and to a bunch of miscarriages of justice. Now, all Republicans want to change voting laws because Donald Trump lost and lost fair and square. Now, what say the Republicans that these laws should be changed because your candidate didn't win? When he won against Hillary Clinton, you didn't change anything. Everything stayed the same. Now when he lost, because let's be honest, and I'm through, I won't hold you here no longer. Donald Trump lost by 3.5 million votes to Hillary Clinton. That's the truth on the popular vote. So he really lost that election too. But they were able to steal it thanks to Putin. So if you all want a country ran by a bunch of lying, no good Republicans, that's what you have. Y'all don't even have the hardest white people to replace them, and you all know they need to be replaced. You all needed a stimulus for COVID. Mitch McConnell and the Republican Party voted against it, all of them. You did not get any votes for a stimulus package, which 95% of America won't. Here's another issue. Gun reform. Republicans won't do anything. Let me say this and I'm gone. The only thing Republicans can do is cut taxes. Look at it. Throughout Donald Trump's whole reign, he had everything, the House, the Senate, and they only passed one law, cutting tax for the wealthy, which is what Donald Trump fakes to be. And then here we go again on the treason party. We can't even get justice on the treason party from the Republican Party, which is a treason party. We can't get no justice. They won't even hold a hearing. But when it came to Van Gosley and Hillary Clinton, they held hearings for 9 years. So I'm showing you how dishonest white folks is, and they try to stand up there and say that they're honest, but they're really not. And it's one last thing I want to address. That's Angelico Christus, the most fakest motherfuckers in the world, and all you some bitches gonna bust hell wide open because you ain't nothing but devils trying to play like you a sheep. All the things you do, standing up for Donald Trump, voting for Donald Trump, a liar. Where's the Bible you carry? It doesn't mean anything to you, Angelico Christus. We see that after 4 years of Donald Trump. That's why I have no respect for T.D. Jake, Creflo Dollar, Jesse Duplantis, or none of the rest, because you all stood up there and watched Donald Trump did anything in this world to kill people, and you as saviors, as people of God, said nothing. I'm gone because I know you don't want to hear this. I ain't looking for no views from it. Don't even matter to me. I want it to be known. If one person see it, thank you to the one person who see this and might pick up and take something from it. Maybe I can inspire one person to get up and go fight for office who honest to try to straighten this out for people of color and all people. So I'm telling this just to inspire one person. Thank you all. This is real true street crime telling you it is a disgrace to sit up here and watch Erase the Space by Virgin and Jeff Basil. I turn the TV off every time it's on because I don't care to watch billionaires who do nothing for this country but want to race in spaceships to space. What does that do for the average poor man? Tell me. This is real true street crime. Subscribe, share, and like. And I ain't looking for no hits on this. And matter of fact, go ahead, because I know y'all haters. Give me all thumbs down. Go ahead, because you haters. You can't block the truth out because it's the truth. So give a thumb down. That means nothing. But you a hater, because the truth is going to always bust through sooner or later. This is Real True Street Crime saying subscribe, share, and like. And this message was for all of you because it's honest and true. If you want to watch two billionaires racing the space and they don't do anything, they don't pay taxes, nothing, what's the point of it? You can put my father in jail for not paying taxes. He paid millions of dollars of taxes. His men's worth billions and billions of dollars, and they won't pay anything. What kind of country is this? What happened to the Tea Party? They never was anything of any significance anyway, but crooks and robbers. That's all the Tea Party was. They started up to hurt Obama because he was a black president. I'm out, and I don't want to hold your ear any longer, but I'm saying this and saying the truth. You all need to get rid of this Republican Party because they're killing this country. And if you keep them in power, you may not have a democracy. I'm out. This is Real True Street Crime. Check out Brittany Simmons over there, a fine young attorney. Check out, and she'll help you out. Check out Jelani's Taste and Table, a fine young chef. Check out Top Tier Cuts 313 Super Can for the weekend. Check out Coney Island Chronicle, Coney Island Tony. Check out Big Boss Film, Courtney Brown Jr. Check out Motown Podcast, Motown Mafia Podcast on Spotify. And I got to go, but in the words of the fat man, I'm going to be seeing a lot of you all.